Finally tonight, remember a short while back when they were used just for making phone calls? Well, these days, mobile phones seem to be used for everything except calling home or a friend. Now the latest smarter-than-smartphones are being touted as the new way to pay for things, if you like, as a virtual wallet. Eddie Meyer has been testing the technology.
In a fast-paced world, time is precious. So we're forever searching for ways to make simple tasks faster, easier.
How is the light to pay for it?
And that used to be a simple question. The answer was always cash. FPOS and credit cards changed that, but soon there'll be a new way to pay. Simply wave your phone within a few centimetres of a special reader and walk away.
Customers don't want to know about the specific technology. They want to know about how they can enable their payment with ease at any time, in any place. And for them right now, the phone is the most natural method of doing that.
Our mobiles now do so much more than just make calls, photos, music, the internet, any number of smart applications. That's prompted credit card company Visa to trial mobile phone technology for transactions under $100. It's still studying the results, but believes it's a winner.
In fact, as a participant of the trial, my own experience has been that every time I've used this phone for making small value transactions, people around me and even the retailers have asked me, well, this is brilliant, you know, it makes sense. Where can I get one of these phones?
And it's not just aimed at the young and tech savvy.
With a lot more people carrying smarter phones, particularly iPhones and Blackberries and similar type of smartphones, that the payment appeal is also equally to a much broader demographic.
So how soon before you can turn your mobile into a virtual wallet? At least 18 months, it seems. And almost certainly not before it's been trialled and introduced in the US. And the reason for that delay? The phones themselves.
The Visa trial was designed to test consumer and retailer acceptance. Account details were transferred to a special microSD chip, but that had to be inserted into an iPhone case, a clear stumbling block. Wave and pay in mobiles is unlikely to proceed until the necessary technology is included in the phone itself, which should start happening from the end of the year. Visa says three levels of security are built into the process and transactions are protected in the same way as credit cards. But of course, fraud remains a concern.
If we lose our phone, we can actually stop that phone. We can stop that phone being used, we can turn that number off, we can turn the account off, we can turn all of the enablement of that phone off. If you lose your wallet, you can't turn the cash off. The cash is gone.
And this, they say, could be even more useful for children and teenagers.
They can actually request that money to be transferred to the phone, spend it in safety without actually having to use cash, and more importantly, the parent isn't being asked to actually upload and give their credit card details or their debit card account details to a third-party online provider.
So, in an ever more complicated world, one device may end up at the centre of everything we do, just don't leave home without it.